Hello, I'm Dr. Tracey Marks, a psychiatrist, and I make mental health education videos. Today's video is based on a viewer question from Tangaray, who asks, Dr. Marks, I hate the holidays and get really depressed every single year. Is this the same as seasonal affective disorder? And if so, should I take medication this time of year? Thanks, Tangaray, for your question. So first off, T, many people get sad or feel depressed during the holidays from the stress of expectations, loneliness, missing loved ones who are no longer celebrating the holidays with you. For some people, the dread starts around early November and then drops off shortly after the hustle and bustle ends and the new year begins. Even though this may happen every single year, it's not the same as seasonal affective disorder. It's sadness that's tied to a specific situation, and once that situation has passed, you return to your usual state. We usually refer to this as the holiday blues to describe the situational mood changes, but it's not a clinical disorder. Seasonal affective disorder, or SAD, is a subtype of major depression. The official term is major depressive disorder seasonal pattern. Symptoms include feeling hopeless, having low energy, social withdrawal, and changes in sleep and appetite. For it to be considered SAD, the depressive episodes must follow a seasonal pattern for 2 consecutive years. Also, the symptoms tend to last several months. There are 2 types of SAD, and they look a little different from each other. There's a fall onset SAD, also called winter depression, that begins in the late fall or early winter. Common symptoms with this are oversleeping, increased appetite, especially craving carbohydrates, which is unfortunate timing for the holiday parties, and then weight gain. You can also feel really tired, like you could just stay in bed all day. Or even if you are up and about, you can have low energy or hardly any stamina. It's like you get worn down really easily. People often feel the need to hibernate or withdraw socially. The winter onset is the most common form of SAD. The second form of SAD is a spring onset, also called summer depression. This starts in the late spring or early summer. And these symptoms look a little different from the winter form, as the sleep problem tends to be trouble sleeping or poor appetite, leading to weight loss, restlessness, agitation, and anxiety. And it's like an agitated, amped up form of depression. It's not the same as hypomania because your mood state is still low and negative, but it can look similar to hypomania, as the anxiety or worry can be mistaken for racing thoughts. How can you tell the difference? One key difference between the racing thoughts of hypomania and anxiety is usually fear-based or causes worry and fretting. The racing thoughts with hypomania could be about anything. You're not necessarily worrying, but your thoughts are moving fast from one thing to the next. Another difference between this agitated summer depression and the hypomania is how the energy is expressed. With depression, the increased activation is agitation and restlessness. You may be pacing and feeling like you can't sit still or don't feel comfortable in your skin, and you just want to scream or swing at someone. With hypomania, you have increased energy that's more focused. You may be organizing closets, developing new business ideas, gambling, or having affairs. It's like increased productivity that's a little too excessive to be completely beneficial. The exact cause of SAD is not fully understood, but some thoughts are that the decreased sunlight in the fall and winter disrupt your circadian rhythm. Your body clock is on a 24-hour schedule that controls your sleep, but also it controls other body processes. Disrupting this schedule disrupts your body's overall homeostasis, and this includes your mood. Another possible cause is that less sunlight causes decreased serotonin activity, and low levels of serotonin increase the risk of developing depression. Here's how sunlight affects serotonin. Serotonin is made from tryptophan inside the nerves that start in your midbrain. These nerves are called presynaptic neurons, and they project to other parts of the brain. At their destination, they pair up with a postsynaptic neuron. This is how nerves communicate with each other. We'll call this setup for now nerve 1 and nerve 2. Nerve 1 releases serotonin into the space called the synapse. The serotonin floats around and binds to receptors on nerve 2. Have you ever played that musical chair game where The music plays and you walk around the chairs, and there's not enough chairs for everyone to sit down. When the music stops, everyone scrambles to sit down, and anyone left standing has to leave the game. This is a similar situation. Serotonin is released from nerve 1, and there are only so many receptors or chairs for the serotonin to bind to. The serotonin that binds to the mood-regulating receptors on nerve 2 are granted entry into the cell, and then it gets a chance to work its magic in regulating mood. The free-roaming serotonin gets scooped up by a serotonin transport protein called SERT. SERT is like the police picking up people off the street, and it takes the unbound serotonin and sends it back to nerve 1. Inside nerve 1, the serotonin either gets recycled for parts or stored for later use. Why do you need to know all this? Because most therapies to improve depression are all about the SERT. Antidepressants increase serotonin availability by blocking SERT. That's how they block reuptake. Keeping SERT away gives the loose serotonin a chance to wait around until there's more available receptors to bind to. And here's where sunlight comes in. Sunlight also blocks SERT, or at least keeps the numbers down. So there's less police around to scoop up the serotonin. When you have less sunlight in the fall and winter, SERT replicates unchecked, and there's more of it to remove serotonin before the serotonin has a chance to bind. Two more possible causes, or at least associations. People with SAD are thought to have high melatonin levels, and these high levels contribute to feeling tired and sluggish, especially with the winter subtype. There's also some evidence to suggest that vitamin D may play a role in SAD. Since vitamin D is produced in your skin from sun exposure, reduced sunlight in the winter months can lead to vitamin D deficiency. Vitamin D deficiency is linked to depression, but it's not a proven cause of depression. But because of this link, it's recommended to restore your vitamin D to normal levels. And so that's one intervention for SAD, vitamin D supplementation. It's always best to get your vitamin D levels checked, and labs can vary in what they consider to be the normal range. But in general, less than 20 nanograms per milliliter is considered deficient. If you're that low, your doctor will likely prescribe a high-dose tablet or capsule of 50,000 international units per week. How long you take it depends on how your body absorbs it. A typical course, though, may be 6 to 12 weeks. You do not want to do this on your own by taking a bunch of vitamin D that you purchase over the counter. Vitamin D is a fat-soluble vitamin, which means that it gets stored in your body, and you can get toxic if you take too much of it. So you'll need to restore a vitamin D deficiency under a doctor's supervision. Many people, though, have low levels and don't know it. An adequate level of vitamin D is 40 to 60 nanograms per milliliter. If you spend a lot of time indoors, wear sunscreen, or have darker skin, you could be on the low end of the range. If you fall into any of these categories and you feel sluggish or just not at your best, you should get your level checked. However, that said, even if you don't get your level checked, daily supplementation of 1,000 to 2,000 international units can help you stay in the adequate or optimal range. While we're talking about vitamin D, what's the difference between vitamin D3 and D2? Vitamin D2 comes from plant sources like fungi or certain types of yeast. It can also be produced synthetically. Vitamin D3 is the form of vitamin D that is synthesized in your skin when it's exposed to sunlight. It also comes from animal-based dietary sources such as fatty fish or cod liver oil, or it can also be produced synthetically. Both D3 and D2 are converted in your body to the active form that is called 25-hydroxyvitamin D. And it's this 25-hydroxy form that's measured in blood tests. In general, though, vitamin D3 is considered to be more efficient at raising your level because it's better absorbed by your intestines. A second thing you can do if you have the winter version is to use a light therapy box that has an intensity of 10,000 lux. This 10,000 lux is the equivalent of being exposed to a mix of direct and indirect sunlight. I talk in detail about how to use a light box in a video on getting morning sunlight. I'll have it linked to this video. Using light therapy is not recommended for the summer depression, and it can make it worse given the abundance of light during these seasons. In this case, you may want to try antidepressants if you're not already on them, or have your doctor tweak your medication regimen for the 6 months around spring and summer seasons. So going back to T's original question, the answer is, if your sadness is situationally focused on the holidays and resolves after it's over, antidepressants aren't really warranted and may not do much for you. You'll want to find other things to do to distract yourself from what's going on around you. Seasonal affective disorder is a form of major depression that usually lasts for several months, usually 6 or more. Antidepressants work better for sad, as does light therapy, if you have the winter form, though. You should always consult a doctor for an evaluation if you have any questions about how to handle your specific circumstance. Thanks to the Mental Wellness Space store for supporting this video. I am the creator of this online store that offers products like canvas prints, wall posters, tumblers, shirts, digital workbooks, and other tools designed to promote mental wellness. It's wellness woven into everyday life, reflecting my mission to integrate mental well-being into daily living. It's about celebrating and elevating mental health. And just as the shirt says, mental health commands a seat at the table. Join me in pulling up a chair and bringing mental health into everyday conversation. Watch this video for more on using light therapy. Thank you for watching today. See you next time.